Hi everyone, welcome back to Dad Bod. I'm Josh, and today we got a really good topic. It's 10 things that fathers should do every 2 weeks. So let's just dive right in, okay? So number one is grooming. Your whole self, take care of yourself. Get your hair cut, trim your beard, manscape, toenails, fingernails, the whole shebang. Just take care of yourself and keep your image good. And not only for looking good and sleek and professional, increasing your odds in the professional business world and etc., but also just for the sake of taking care of yourself. You know, having kids can be very hectic, and we often, as parents, forget to take care of ourselves and give ourselves basic human needs like eating on time, showering. Taking care of ourselves, we're always making sure the kids get their haircuts and their food and their showers, and by the time at end of the day, we're just tired. So every 2 weeks, make sure that that you're taking care of your image. So number two is going to be washing your bed sheets, and this is really important because when you go to bed, it's your time to rejuvenate and let your body heal and rest up. And bed sheets, you know, when we're sleeping, we're sweaty, dead skin cells coming off, dirt, you know, you're making babies, it gets dirty, right? So make sure that you clean those sheets so that you can be healthy and you can have a nice, clean, calm environment to sleep in. So number three is going to be weigh yourself every 2 weeks. And this is not so much to be like hyper-focused on your weight or your image. It's basically just to kind of keep tabs on your eating habits and how healthy you are. It's not the end-all, be-all, your weight, when it comes to knowing how healthy you are. But if you just check every 2 weeks, and as long as you're the same or a little bit lower, even if it's a pound over, you know, as long as it's not a constant climb 1 pound every month or every 2 weeks, you're doing good. But weighing yourself every 2 weeks can give you a heads up. Hey, maybe I am gaining 1 pound or half a pound every 2 weeks, and that's not a good direction to be heading. So in the spirit of taking care of yourself, weigh yourself every 2 weeks and just make sure that your eating habits are aligning with where you want to be. So number four is going to be managing finances. And so this is going to be making sure that you pay all your bills, or you have a system to pay the bills, and every 2 weeks you're making sure that the monies are going in the right accounts, making sure that you actually have as much as you think you do, because oftentimes we just don't look at the accounts for too long, and then we wind up in trouble, right? So make sure you check that credit card, check your checkings and savings accounts, make sure it's where you've planned them to be, and make the appropriate adjustments. Number five is going to be date your wife, okay? Date your wife. I know we're talking about being fathers, but in order to be a good father, you have to be a good husband. They come together. Usually, unless, you know, things have gone awry, but the ideal situation is, right, is that you're a husband who becomes a father, right? And so it's all your family, and you want to make sure that you're showing your kids, right? This is huge. How a relationship should be, because as they get older and they're going to experience, you know, the whole world of Hollywood, and they're going to find the internet, and they're going to find porn, and those aren't accurate representations of what love is and what a healthy marriage is. So for your kids, but also for the sake of your marriage, date your wife. Let them know that, you know, when you find a woman, right, if you show your sons that when you find a woman, you treat her well and with respect, and you spend time with her, and your daughters are going to recognize that behavior, and they're going to want to look for men who also do that. So it's a good role model experience. And in addition to that, take care of your wife. I mean, she's in this too. I know we're talking about fatherhood, but she's dealing with motherhood as well. And so taking that time to appreciate her for all her endeavors is a good thing. You should do it. So do it. Let's see, number six, call a friend. Okay, call a friend that you haven't talked to in a while, or maybe you don't talk to on a regular basis. So every 2 weeks, it doesn't have to be the same friend. It could be. You know, I have one best friend, and we will talk multiple times a week and talk for hours. But it doesn't have to be that. It could be, you know, a friend that you haven't talked to in a while. Maybe you just want to catch up. Keep that connection going, because just like I was talking about relationship with your wife and your kids, you also need to keep up those relationships outside of your family, because having friends is really healthy for you, for your mentality, because it can't always be, your mind can't always be focused on like, okay, am I being a good dad? Am I doing my job right? Am I paying the bills that the kids can eat? I mean, those are important things, but you also need to have a social life. Again, it's a role model thing, and it's also for your own mental health. And it's also good connections too, because, you know, sometimes you'll find yourself in need of help, and then you will have those friends, that network and support group that you can turn to. Okay, so call your friends. Let's see, number seven is going to be donate to something. Okay, donate your time, donate your money, donate some items. It doesn't matter, just donate something, because life isn't all about us. We want to especially show our children that generosity and charity are good things. And again, it goes along with our mindset of if we're always home and we're always just kind of in this frantic state of running around after the kids and doing working our jobs and then trying to sleep where we can, it becomes monotonous and very taxing on the mind. So being able to bring yourself out of that and help someone else, not focus on your own stresses and issues, but help someone else with theirs, it's really good for the mind to alleviate that stress. And you actually usually feel better. Most people feel better on the inside as well. That's the only reason you should do it. You should do it to help people. But a good byproduct of that is you're going to feel good inside. And some of your stresses just magically go away once you help other people. So donate is a good thing to do. After that, number eight is going to be stock up. So this past year, with everything that has been so crazy, from politics to, you know, the medical world, it's just been crazy, right? And nobody, well, I shouldn't say nobody. A lot of people just didn't think that something like this could happen. I don't know why people didn't think this stuff could happen. It's happened since the dawn of time. Issues arise, disasters happen, shortages occur, and we need to have resources to be able to weather that, especially as a family. If you have children, you're going to need to make sure that you have diapers, wipes, foods, whatever it is. And so what I do, me and my family, is we'll just do a low budget, okay, every week, or in this case, every 2 weeks, we'll take, you know, $20, $25, and we will go and buy extra supplies, whether that be food, medicine, clothes, etc., so that slowly over time we build up a good safety net. So when something hits, a recession hits, a pandemic hits, God forbid there's a war, natural disaster, you know, especially if you live in those areas where there's tornadoes or there's going to be floods, having that extra supplies is going to make the difference in your survival. So think about that. Think about how you can prepare every 2 weeks. All right, number nine is cook family dinner. So I don't know how you have it set up at your house, but whether you do the cooking or your wife does it, or you have your kids help out, that's all great. But every 2 weeks, make a good effort to cook dinner for the family and kind of create an atmosphere that is family time and bonding. And I'm sure your wife would love it. I'm sure you'll get brownie points for that. And it's also a good skill to have, and a skill that eventually you can pass on to your children as they're getting older. You can teach them how to cook and make cooking and taking care of yourself a good habit, normalize it, right? Because there's like going, just like your kids growing up, right? They'll go to school, they'll learn algebra, they'll learn calculus, and those are all great things. But do they know how to cook? A lot of my friends that I met in college, they didn't know how to cook. And that's kind of crazy because they're out into the adult world, as they call it. And one of the basic human needs to cook food so you can eat, they didn't have that skill. So I'm sure they could slightly not burn something, but nothing tasted good, right? But being able to generally make some good dishes goes a long way for your mental state and then and your mood, and then obviously for your physical health. So cook family dinner, show your kids that it's important, it's a good skill, and that it's everyone's job to make sure that you can eat, right? And last but not least, we have indulge in a hobby. Okay, so whatever hobby that you are into, that you love, maybe you don't have much time to do it, maybe you do, but every 2 weeks, just set aside a good chunk of time. Take a Saturday and be like, all right, tell your wife, like, hey, honey, I want to take 4 hours today, I just kind of want to relax today, and I just want to play video games, I want to, work on the car, I want to, go hunting, go to the range, I want to go fishing, you want to draw, whatever it is, right? Just take some time to do it, because, like I said earlier, it's not always, life can't always be this rushing thing, rushing out the door with the kids and, paying the bills and working. I mean, those are all your responsibilities, but you need to plan and make time for yourself and make sure that you are living life as well, and taking care of your mental state, right? Because life gets crazy. So those are 10 things that fathers should do every 2 weeks. And it's especially important to note that being a father is not always specifically about engaging with your children. Like, all right, I'm going to teach you a lesson today. We're going to learn about finances today. Or son or daughter, we're going to, learn how to exercise today, et cetera. Like, doesn't have to be so specifically engaged with them. It's about being the role model. You are the first and primary role model, and ideally you want to be the best role model. So taking care of yourself, always growing and learning and adapting are going to be some good traits to include, and be that role model. Show your kids that life isn't all about the craziness of the business world and the social media world. You just need to take some time to take care of yourself, okay? So I really hope that helped, and we will see you guys in the next video. Thanks.